When you live on the Pacific Ring of Fire, now and then you're gonna get burned.
I never really thought I'd believe this or say this, but at this moment, I honest to God believe I'm dead.
I heard a sound and I just looked over my shoulder.
It was the last eruption on the West Coast.
I saw this mushroom cloud go up above the volcano and climb rapidly up into the stratosphere.
Mount St. Helens became the biggest volcanic disaster in the history of the U.S. 60 people killed, ash spread over 11 states. But the first eruption ever to occur in what is now the United States? It was Lassen Peak blowing its top in California, and that is where we're headed tonight. Good evening, I'm Brian Hackney, and for the next two nights, Eye on the Bay takes the show on the road to California volcano country. We'll get in some hot water. We'll canoe right in the shadow of the volcano. We'll head to the upper Sacramento River to see what we can hook.
Catching a fish is a bonus.
And we'll sample Lake Shasta, up close and personal. That's the ultimate destination, Mount Shasta, 270 miles from San Francisco. And getting here, that's a trip.
We began by heading east out of the city at 8 a.m., crossed the Carquinez Bridge at Crockett by 8:45, hooked up with Interstate 5 heading north, past the mysterious Sutter Buttes north of Sacramento, and by 11:15 a.m. hit the town of Red Bluff, 180 miles north of San Francisco. From Red Bluff, we head east on Highway 36, push 50 miles into the mountains by 12:15 p.m.,
and finally we arrive at Lassen Volcano National Park.
Lassen Peak is rugged, scenically stunning, and sometimes stinky.
It's like we come over the pass, and I'm telling Lynn, I'm going, what's that smell?
What do you think of the smell?
A fart.
Like a fart?
It's more politely known as hydrogen sulfide, one sign that this is very much an active volcano.
There are more than 30 volcanic domes in the park. Lassen's the biggest, formed by very thick lava piling up on itself till it piled 10,457 feet high. It's one of the largest lava domes on Earth. It formed about 27,000 years ago. But that's not the last time it was heard from.
It's the first and last time that a California volcano has erupted in modern times. .400 eruptions between 1914 and 1921, Lassen hasn't completely quieted down yet.
What I have behind me is a steam vent or a fumarole. And no matter what time of year you come up here, whether there's 8 feet of snow or during the summer, you're gonna see steaming vents over here.
That's Park Ranger Karen, and she's going to do something that's almost unique to Lassen. That is, just take a 30-mile trip.
Very cool.
And hit all the hot spots.
So here we are at Lake Helen. We are at the Sulfurworks area.
Broke off volcano?
It's stop number two along the park road guide.
While it would take you a long time to roam Yosemite, Lassen can be boiled down to a 30-mile scenic road trip. Bay Area tourists are loving it.
It was a really pretty drive coming into here, seeing all the redwoods. You could actually smell it.
It reminds me of like a little Yellowstone.
Well, this is definitely a surprise. I was not expecting to see any mud pots or anything like that.
A five-hour hike takes you to the very top of Lassen Peak.
We have 150 miles of hiking trails. There's lakes to swim in as well as boat on and fish.
And this lake is in one of the most beautiful settings in any national park.
We're paddling on Manzanita Lake. This lake was formed with a giant rockfall from the Chaos Crags area.
This is gorgeous. We've got the whole lake to ourselves.
We have black-tailed deer. You might have been shadowed some days by a bald eagle, and of course lots of ground squirrels.
But there's not that many of these animals.
Whether it's wilderness, beautiful scenery, hydrothermals, you can see most of it within a day's hike or a day's drive.
That's going to wrap up a long day at Lassen Peak. The Bay Bridge seems like a long time ago, but we're not done yet. We're going to bed down for the night, and that stop is a spectacular one. Wait until you see Drake's Bed. After a break.
Okay, you here better we go. Get over.
I thought you were steering.
I'm fine.
Welcome back to Eye on the Bay. I'm Brian Hackney as we continue our journey into the volcanoes of Northern California. And this is not just for show. This is the only source of illumination at the place where we are bedding down for the night. Let me tell you about Drake's Bed. It is one remote, cool place. Dust down a country
road. First, you take a trip 11 miles down an unpaved road and a century back in time. Welcome to Drake's Bed Resort.
And we heard that there was a ranch and a corral and hot springs and food. And everybody that hikes the trail knows about Drake's Bed.
The trail is the nearby Pacific Crest Trail. This group's hiking a part of it.
We've come across so much hospitality on this trail. It's just unbelievable.
Hi, have a good horseback ride.
That hospitality comes from the innkeepers.
We fell in love with the place, so I called them up and said, hey, you need a manager?
Ed and his wife have been running the place since 1989.
She's actually the boss, of course.
With horse stables, a ranch house, 14 rooms of one kind or another, most without electricity, and a hydrothermal pool, no wonder people come from all over the world to stay at Drake's Bed.
The rewards are great. One of the rewards is that we make a lot of new friends.
And it really is true. The electricity goes out here at 10 o'clock at night. And so do we until sunrise tomorrow. The horses, the hammocks, the food, the people. Drake's Bed.
Drake's good.
Why are there volcanoes in California?
There's volcanoes in California because we have subduction off the coast of North America. They exist because of the subduction of the oceanic plate off of the north coast of California, which causes melting in the deep earth. And that molten rock comes up to the surface and then erupts.
From Lassen to Hawaiian volcanoes and beyond.
We made it! We're at 10,000 feet!
They're all part of the Pacific Ring of Fire that extends all the way from the volcanoes here in Northern California, around the Pacific Basin, to the volcanoes in the Indonesian islands.
That Ring of Fire includes the Cascade Range, 13 major volcanoes on a 700-mile arc in the Pacific Northwest.
Love is a burning thing.
75% of Earth's volcanoes circle the Pacific.
And it makes a fiery ring.
Among them, Mount Hood, Mount Shasta, Mount St. Helens, Mount Lassen, and its Field of Steams.
It's really amazing. It's the largest hydrothermal field of any of these Cascade volcanoes. Which brings us back to the name of this famous stop.
It's Bumpus Hell.
Where did they come up with that name?
It's actually named after a man. It became Bumpus's Hell because he broke through the crust and severely burnt his leg.
I fell into a burning ring of fire.
Which only goes to prove you get too close to the Pacific Ring of Fire, you're gonna get burned.
Burns, burns, burn. The Ring of Fire, the Ring of Fire.
Well, that's where we've been, Mount Lassen so far, but now it's time to begin to head to the next hop in the chain of Cascade volcanoes, and the next one, 70 miles to the north. There's the destination, Mount Shasta. But the great thing about visiting these parks is not so much those destinations as it is these cool little points of interest around them. Case in point, Burney Falls is one of those places. It's just about 40 miles outside of the park. The falls are 129 feet high. 100 million gallons of water discharged a day. It's just one of these great little places to stop. And the next place is one of the great little towns to stop. You come out here, everybody talks about the town of McLeod.
It's in the very shadow of Mount Shasta.
It always has a different face, the mountain.
Just an amazing setting to live by.
McLeod, that's our next stop.
Looking good.
And we'll get a fly fishing lesson.
Have you ever hooked yourself in the face?
I have hooked myself in the face.
When Eye on the Bay's tour of California volcano country continues. Oh, but first, I almost forgot. I wanted to show you this video flashback to a trip that we took down Highway 395 in the Eastern Sierra. I had a blast wading in the magma-fueled Hot Creek Geyser. That was just south of a famed mountain that might be the site of California's next big blast.
We're at the Mammoth Lake Ski Resort right now, and most people come here to ski. But I gotta tell you, I love Mammoth Lakes because the next time you hear about a volcano going off in California, the likelihood is it's going to happen here. And they got a warning shot across the bow in 1980. In one 24-hour period, one day, they got four magnitude sixes. So the town went into an uproar. It didn't help that at the same time, Mount St. Helens had just erupted. This town was shaken up, and for good reason, because this whole thing has blown before. And by this whole thing, I mean this entire valley went up in smoke about 630,000 years ago. I mean, the crater that you see up there, that's the rim of a volcano. It went so explosive back then that they have found parts of California in Nebraska. Welcome back to Eye on the Bay. I'm Brian Hackney as our tour of Northern California volcano country continues. Next, time to push toward the tiny town of McLeod, heading northwest from mighty Lassen Peak when suddenly it appears. Mighty Mount Shasta.
And to be able to get up every day and to see the mountain, to me, it's just an amazing setting to live by.
It's all part of a day in the life of McLeod, California.
Things are so much simpler. You don't have to spend money on a lot of things that you spend money on in the city, you know? Since I've moved here, I have no use for all my suits. Yeah, all my suits are down in the basement now.
Darlene runs the McLeod River Inn. Take a look at the rooms.
We went a little different than the other hotels for just a couple, but then I also have larger suites for families. And then we also have the beautiful suites that show that are also a great honeymoon retreat that have a view of the mountain.
The looming Mount Shasta is a big part of McLeod's appeal.
I think Mount Shasta is an amazing mountain.
And Deborah Anderson would know. She runs another inn, the century-old McLeod Guest House.
Southern charm, wide porch, and no wonder. It was built for the man who owned McLeod.
His name was Mr. Queel. He was actually a lumber baron. It was originally built 9 bedrooms, 6 bathrooms.
Now the inn has 7 bedrooms for their guests to fit Deborah's theme.
We're a romantic inn. So we're always looking for couples who are looking for romance to come to McLeod and stay at the McLeod Guest House.
And talk about famous. William Randolph Hearst was a guest here. He gave the family this pool table. If you're a guest here, you can play on it. Or you could stay in room number 1. President Herbert Hoover did back in the 30s. It's a cute place. But what do they do for fun around here?
12 o'clock stop, forward. 12 o'clock stop, forward.
Yep, Rick Cox is teaching me to fly fish on the front lawn.
Beautiful. Back hard, forward lightly.
We ready for the real thing?
We're getting there.
The real thing's the Upper Sacramento River. Then I think I'm ready.
There you go.
I hooked the lawn.
We got the lawn.
I got one. I've got a blade of grass. We'll see if I perfect that technique by tomorrow night. When our tour of the California volcanoes continues, we're going to get a tour of the Shasta Caverns, some amazing sights. Also, we'll spend a night on the lake you will never forget, and we'll be in the upper Sacramento River seeing if we can hook anything.
I did hook something.
That's tomorrow night on our tour of California volcanoes. For now, I'm Brian Hackney. Here's hoping you get into some hot water along the way. We'll see you tomorrow. From the upper Sacramento River, 250 miles north of San Francisco, I'm Brian Hackney, and welcome to part two of our tour of volcano country.
Shasta, we love it!
Mount Hood, Mount St. Helens, Mount Rainier. They're all part of a chain of volcanoes in the Cascade Range. But one volcano, just 200 miles north of San Francisco, was one of the last to pop off. Lassen Peak hasn't simmered down yet. That's where we stopped yesterday.
Tonight, off for the next volcano.
Off to Shasta. Along the way, we'll pay a fascinating visit to the second largest structure of its kind in the United States.
It's almost a mile long.
Damn. We'll take a ski boat ride to one of the most amazing sights on Shasta Lake. Or should I say, inside Shasta Lake. And we'll see if I can do something I haven't tried since high school.
Love it!
But first, how did I end up knee-deep in the upper Sacramento River? It all began with this man early this morning and the city of Dunsmuir. This is the scene on I-5, 270 miles north of San Francisco. In the shadow of Mount Shasta, the tiny town of Dunsmuir is famous for fly fishing. Of course, if you're going to go fly fishing, then you've got to go, what the hell is that? A praying mantis. Insect species Mantidae, approximately the size of a house cat.
You ruined my stand-up.
Well, what I was going to say was, if you're gonna go fly fishing, you've gotta go fly shopping. The Ted Fay Fly Shop is the place to get them.
It's supposed to be the oldest continuously operated fly fishing shop in California?
Probably.
Ted Fay opened the shop in the early 50s. Bob's been running it since 1997.
The time came and I decided that I wanted to move away from the Bay Area. This was very high on the list.
How is the fishing around here, by the way?
It's good.
So, one fishing license later?
Your draft notice will be to you in the mail here shortly.
And now it's time to hook up with Rick. Rick is the fly guy in Dunsmuir.
Some people get it very rapidly and others not so rapidly.
After having a lesson on the lawn yesterday.
Beautiful.
We're ready for the real thing today.
What, do I look stupid? Do I look that stupid?
Yeah. This is the Upper Sacramento River around Dunsmuir. It's all rainbow trout in here. Okay, Brian, I think you're ready to give it a try.
Okay.
Here we go.
All right.
That's good. Now you elevate your rod tip a little bit. Good. Good start right there. You're getting it.
Is it proper to ask how many fish are even in this river?
Sure. There's 3,000 to 4,000 fish per mile.
Wow.
If you break that down, that's like one fish every 2 feet.
There's one fish per every 2 feet, and not one of them likes my fly.
Not yet.
Not that it's all about the fish.
A lot of osprey, a lot of bald eagles.
You ever see any bear?
I see bear frequently, yes.
In fact, earlier this morning, we answered the question, does a bear do you know what in the woods? Yes, ladies and gentlemen, there is the evidence.
That was one big bowel movement. It's a healthy bear and he's eating good.
The great outdoors. That's what it's all about.
I've seen it become such a passion with some people that it has actually broken up marriages. I've seen it work the other way too, where it has solidified a marriage.
What's also cool about this is to think
This is the beginning, near the beginning of the Sacramento River.
That's correct.
This vast, broad river that joins with the San Joaquin and forms the enormous delta that ultimately flows out the Golden Gate.
That's correct.
But one of the largest man-made objects on Earth stands in between.
It's the largest reservoir in the state of California.
Damn. Shasta Dam's about 60 miles downstream from where Rick and I are fishing.
How many towns did they have to drown to build the dam?
Actually, when they start filling up the reservoir, there were about 5 towns, about 3,000 folks.
But bring on a 9-mile-long conveyor belt to mix 12 million tons of gravel into the concrete that would raise the face of the largest dam ever built in California. The hydroelectrics alone pump out enough power to electrify Santa Clara County.
Another fun fact, man, is it tall. I mean, the distance from the bottom of Shasta Dam to the top of the dam, 602 feet. That's the height of 4 Statues of Liberty.
One other huge thing, the accomplishment of the 4,800 men who began the work at the tail end of the Great Depression, who bulldozed the mountain, who overcame the flood that wiped out 2 years' worth of work, and who finished the dam in 1945.
The people who built this dam, are there some of them still around?
There are some still around. This was finished in 1945, and we every year have a dam workers reunion, and we have gentlemen still coming back that are in their hundreds, and it is so delightful to talk to these people, and they would do it again in a heartbeat. They made this what this is.
Meanwhile, 50 miles upriver.
I have hooked something. Look at the rod, look at the rod. The rod is bent. It's somebody else's line. We have hooked somebody else's line.
And that's about the only thing we were able to snag.
Now, catching a fish is a bonus.
All right, well, we're still gonna see if we can catch something during the commercial break, but still ahead, we're gonna continue up I-5 in the shadow of Mount Shasta and see it in a way you have never seen it before. As Eye on the Base tour of Volcano Country continues after a break. Welcome back to Eye on the Bay, or in this case, Eye on beautiful Mount Shasta. I'm Brian Hackney, and you know, you don't have to leave the Bay Area in order to see Volcano Country. You might just want to come here. I'm at the top of Mount Diablo, not because Diablo's a volcano, but because on a clear day, you can come here to the top, look in that direction, and see Mount Lassen from 200 miles away. And if you were here in 1915, you might have seen one of the area's many eruptions. They date back 600,000 years. In fact, one eruption from Lassen was so big that it blew ash all the way to Carmel. In fact, you can see the layer of Lassen ash all the way back in the Bay Area. It's right here at Funston Beach. See that little strip of white about 7 feet from the top of the cliffs? That's a layer of ash from an ancient Lassen area eruption. I mean, look at this, cemented Lassen ash all the way down here in the Bay Area. Isn't that cool? And in fact, you don't need to look all the way to Lassen Peak anyway.
Do we have remnants of volcanoes in the Bay Area?
Yes, we do. There's actually a park called the Sibley Volcanic Park in the Berkeley Hills that has remnants of 11 million-year-old volcanoes.
It's not the classic shape of a volcano like you'd find in the Cascade Range, 13 major peaks that run from Canada south to California. And where is the southernmost Cascade volcano? It's not necessarily Mount Lassen. The location of that southern volcano is an eerie mystery that rises not in the mountains of Northern California, but in one of the flattest places on Earth, the Northern Sacramento Valley.
Flat, except for the weird topographical boil on the horizon, the Sutter Buttes.
Oh, the Sutter Buttes are the most peculiar volcanoes in the United States.
They are volcanoes.
They are volcanoes. They're a million years old. They're not really part of the Cascades proper.
Really? Okay.
But they're formed by very, very deep melting in the Earth's crust because they have very strange mineral compositions.
And could it be the southernmost of the mighty Cascade volcanoes?
It could be.
It could be.
It could be. But most people would consider Mount Lassen the southernmost of the Cascade volcanoes proper.
So off from the buttes, off from Lassen, off to the next in the chain of California volcanoes,
off to Shasta.
You're coming up Interstate 5, and you round the bend, and you see it fill your windshield. It takes your breath away.
Yeah.
It's like, whoa.
It's beautiful. It just kind of takes over all the landscape. Mount Shasta does something for people kind of in their philosophical sense. It's a great place to feel expansive.
It was also a mecca for artists in the 19th century.
As an artist, you were almost expected to have done Mount Shasta paintings.
Why?
Because it was an icon of California. Because it was the symbol of the route going north and south. It just dominates Northern California. That's why.
It certainly dominates the tiny towns that live in its shadow. And it is the second most active of the Cascade volcanoes.
Sure, there's times when you just think, you know, God, I'm scared it's going to happen. You're living on the slopes of a volcano. What could be more idiotic, you know, in terms of safety?
Are we worried about Shasta erupting? Well, let's sleep on it. Sleep on Lake Shasta, that is. On a houseboat complete with a hot tub. Plus, a tour of the amazing Shasta caverns and... I'll see if I can do something I haven't done since I was a teenager. When I and the Bay's tour of the California volcanoes continues after a break. Welcome back to I and the Bay as we arrive at Shasta Lake in the Jones Valley Resort. I'm Brian Hackney and we're on Shasta Lake. And this is where my family used to come when I was a teenager. We'd come out camping, we learned how to water ski here. But first, while we were roughing it back when I was a kid, man, if you want to stay in style at Shasta, you don't stay around the lake. You stay on the lake in one of these incredible houseboats that Michael Hahn is going to tell us about.
It's designed to sleep 15. This particular model has three private staterooms. The galley is just like what you have at home. Full-size ovens, microwaves, direct TV, Bose surround sound for the entertainment system.
Yes. Complete with hot tub.
Yes, it has a hot tub and has a galley up top here.
Can somebody who has never piloted one of these boats before just get up to speed like that?
Sure.
How fast can these go?
These do about 10 knots.
And I'm just pointing it toward where I want to go. It's not any more sophisticated than that.
Nope.
As for where we're headed, well, Shasta's got 365 miles of coastline.
The other aspect is the wildlife. We have so much wildlife up here. You're in the middle of raw nature. I hear a bald eagle now.
You do?
Yeah.
It really is beautiful, and we're looking forward to bedding down on this tonight, but we still have enough time left in the day for a look at Lake Shasta in a way that you have never seen it before. For that, we need a different kind of boat. It's a wake center ski boat, and it's about a 15-minute trip. We're heading up toward the Interstate 5 bridge. Now we're going to take a right-hand turn up the McLeod River. And before you know it... you're on Mr. Tote's wild ride up to one of the most amazing sights in Northern California.
We're ascending into the Lake Shasta Caverns, six large rooms of bizarre stalactites and stalagmites.
We're headed to the dome room right now.
How many stairs are there?
It's about 600 total.
How many people take this tour?
About 50 to 70,000 a year.
How did these form?
It's just drip by drip coming down through the mountain. It's basically just rainwater. That water flows through the soil that's on the limestone, forming a weak carbonic acid. It's just like what's in soda. And if you drink too much soda, it eats away at the lining of your teeth, gives you cavities. That's what happens to this mountain.
The mountain's cavities have attracted 2.5 million people. The first European to see them was James Richardson. He burned his initials into the walls on November 11th, 1878.
Carbide lanterns is what they would have had back then. This is actually written with soot from the carbide lanterns.
The initials have survived more than a century. the bizarre formations for millions of years.
Incredible. And I appreciate you showing us around. Joshua, thank you so much.
Yeah, you're welcome.
And just like that, that's going to wrap up this trip, the tour of Lassen and Mount Shasta. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope they enjoyed it. Ladies and gentlemen, on your right, that's Henry Kaiser, our producer. On the left, the talented Branson Tarr, Branson, who took the camera through the upper Sacramento River to shoot that fly fishing scene. Branson, what was your favorite part?
I like the fly fishing. The water moving, you guys out there doing the thing. It looked like it was supposed to look.
All right, Branson likes the fly fishing, Henry?
Absolutely, seeing Mount Shasta for the first time up close and personal. It was absolutely fantastic. It was the prettiest mountain I've ever seen.
Worth the trip.
Absolutely.
Hope it was worth the trip for you as well. Hope you get up here and see some of this. We enjoyed bringing it to you, and we appreciate your watching. I'm Brian Hackney. I mean it when I say good night. See you next time.
Wait a minute. I gotta know. Can I still do this for the first time since high school?
Let's give it a shot.
All right, hit it.